We're a few blocks west of the Inner Harbor at Oriole Park here in Baltimore. Opening night here in this brand new season between the Cleveland Indians and the Baltimore Orioles. Orioles baseball comes your way next.
Left fielder.
Michael Brantley is in to start things off here as he looks at a called strike. It's nothing and one. Boy, in a perfect spot for the splitter there. It's 0-2. And here's a ball hit in the air, but no chance to run it down. It's a foul ball. Chopped weakly to the left. Machado charging this one. One away. So here's Francisco Lindor now. First pitch coming. Here it is. A fastball, and he swings through it to fall behind. The windup and the 0-1. And the changeup is way low that time. A 1-1 count. Here's the pitch. And he takes one off the inside corner for ball two. Into the windup. Here's the 2-1 pitch. Way out in front.
Beautifully thrown splitter right there. High 80s, down in the zone. Looks like a fastball coming in, and then it just drops off the table. You can get a lot of swinging strikes with that.
Now a fastball inside, and he works it back to a full count now.
That one missed, but if it's a strike, I don't know how you get the barrel of that pitch. You have to really be sitting on it to hit a fastball coming in that hard on the inside part of the plate.
Hit hard up the middle. Base hit, and that's their first of the new campaign. And the throw by Jones will not be in time. He's in there at third.
Batting fourth.
Digging in, Jason Kipnis. Great chance to drive in a run here in the early going. Below the knees, one ball, no strikes.
Good take right there. Look.
Off again, and now he's in a 1-2 hole. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Slider stayed too low. Ball two.
Boy, that's a tough pitch to lay off. Even if you know it's coming. Look, two strike slider on the back foot. That's a classic pitch. But he did a nice job laying off.
On to Davis at first. It's a double play, and the side is retired. Here's the center fielder now, Adam Jones. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
Center fielder, Adam Jones.
On the ground up the middle, Lindor takes it in. And he's retired, one away. So the bases are empty with one man gone. And standing in now, the third baseman, Manny Machado. First pitch hacking here, and that's the first strike.
Well, that was unexpected. You're looking for that sinker down. He throws a fastball up. Now he's just changed the game on you. He's forcing you to look somewhere else.
From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. This ball will be chopped foul. One out, nobody on. Ball two. Ready on two balls and two strikes. Here it comes. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. A 2-2 count. Here's the pitch. And he struck him out. Here's Chris Davis now. First cuts for him here with the bases open and two away.
Chris Davis.
Now a swing and a miss. Took something off that one, and it's strike one.
Pretty lucky to get away with that one. There's not a situation ever where you want to throw a high changeup, so I think he'll try to make an adjustment with the next one he throws.
Naquin is going to have room out there as he puts this away. Digging in, the switch hitter, Carlos Santana. He'll step in to start things out here against Kevin Gausman. Up and away to start the inning. It's 1-0. The pitch inside, and he falls behind the hitter now, 2-0.
That pitch right there, he's trying to keep him from getting his arms extended. If it's out over the plate more, he can obviously do a lot of damage with it.
And next will be the versatile Tyler Naquin.
Center fielder, Tyler Naquin.
from the stretch. Toss started to go down after it, and he couldn't hold back. It's strike one. And this is fouled back and out of play. Now this is on the ground to first. We'll see if they can get two. Throw on to second, so they'll get the lead man, and that's all. But he'll put this in his pocket and be content with just the one out. Stepping up to the plate, Jose Ramirez. He'll swing it from the left side right here. Squared that one up just a little late. Now a throw over, and he has to dive, but he's back in easily. From the belt, the pitch. Pitch outside, the throw. The tag from Hardy, and they get him at second base. Here it comes on one and one. And this is down at knee level as it's chopped foul at home plate. Again, he sends it out of play. Another 1-2 delivery. And he'll just get a piece here as this is chopped foul at home plate. Strike three called, and the inning is over. Here's Mark Trumbo now. He'll start things out here against Corey Kluber. First delivery to him on the way. Fouled off into the seats behind first. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Another one fouled off, and he's quickly behind 0-2. Tried to get him out front, but it's a ball 1-2.
Well, there's that classic strikeout pitch, a changeup down, just didn't get him to go after it.
In the dirt, but swung on and missed. Gomes has it, and he makes the throw to first. Trumbo is retired, and there's one away.
Batting fifth.
And that'll bring up the left-handed hitting outfielder, Hyun-Soo Kim. Hit on the ground down the first baseline. That's a hit, their first of the new season. Here's the catcher, Wellington Castillo. First shot for him here with a runner at first now and one away. Here comes the first pitch. Just a tick behind for a strike.
Well, that is a good pitch. A sinker down with that kind of movement, it is really hard to hit. No wonder he swung and missed.
And this is fouled at the plate. And this will ricochet off of him on the mound. Throw gets him, so they are able to get an out on an unusual play. And hopefully the pitcher's okay.
Designated
hitter. In now is Pedro Alvarez. Opportunity for him here to pick up that runner from second with two away. And that's cut on and missed, 0-1. I had him reaching at thin air that time, and he's very quickly down 0-2.
Well, that's not a good pitch for him to hit. Look, this fella's got so much power, but you got to bring the pitch into the zone. Chasing that one there, right there, I'd go back and throw it to him again.
Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as this side is retired. At the plate, Lonnie Chisenhall. He'll step in to lead it off in the top of the third. Split-fingered pitches in there for strike one. And this misses the outside corner, so it's knotted up at 1-1. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Chop fouled over towards the coaching box. Looking for the strikeout, here's the 1-2. Down the first baseline. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Now a fastball awfully close, but he doesn't get the call. It's 2-2 now. He pulls this one into right. And a base hit, so the leadoff man is on to begin the inning. Here's the catcher, Yan Gomes.
Catcher, Yan
Here comes the first pitch. A called strike over the outside corner. He's ready. Here's the 0-1. A swing and a miss just out in front of that fastball. The 0-2 home seared down the first baseline. And a reach, but it's by him as he couldn't quite get to that ball. Here's Michael Brantley, 0-for-1 here in the early going.
Michael Brantley.
And a strike called at the knees, nothing and one.
That's a nice job of getting ahead right there. This is a tough situation he's in. He's going to have to use all his pitches to get out of this jam.
Lifts it into the air to shallow center. Jones is under it, makes the play, one away. And neither runner will be able to move up. And it's a wasted chance with one out in the inning now. Riding in once again, Francisco Lindor reached base via the walk in his first plate appearance. First pitch here misses wide, 1-0. Here comes the 1-0. That's wide, 2-0.
Well, they walked him the first AB, and clearly he's already got two balls now. They're not challenging him, but as a hitter, it's very difficult to stay patient. But you have to. This is where you got to be patient and get your pitch.
This is pulled into right. That's in there. Base hit. And not in time as the run scores. Digging in to try it again. Edwin Encarnacion. A base hit in his first trip. Comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. And a ball 1-0. And he comes back with one in there for a high strike. Clearly trying to control the running game with the slide step here.
Yeah, that's a good way of trying to control the running game. Now, the problem with it, though, handoff because you're worrying about that runner on base.
Is there, and he's out trying to take second. He's set, and the 2-1 pitch. Now a swing and a chopper foul right at home plate. And look out as that fastball ran in and got him. Ouch, man. And is the second baseman, Jason Kipnis. Two on, two out for him here in the third. And that misses for ball one. He's ready. Here's the 1-0. And he takes a pitch right down the middle. Runners at the corners, two men out. And this one runs in on him as he can't get at the plate. Jonathan Schoop. He'll lead things off here in this one-run contest.
Number six, Jonathan Schoop.
Lays off 1-0.
Ball one, no strike.
Hits slowly back to the mound. And he's retired here, one away. Here's the shortstop now, J.J. Hardy.
The shortstop, J.J. Hardy.
Into the windup and the pitch. Takes a look at one catching the outside corner. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Hit on the ground out to short. Lindor ranges to his left. On to first, and very quickly, two are gone here in the home third.
The center fielder, number 10.
Ready for another chance, Adam Jones. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. First pitch fastball swung on and missed 0-1. I had him guessing that time as he's barely able to foul it away. The windup and the 0-2 pitch. And he'll try and tempt him with one in the dirt, but he'll hold back here. It's 1-2. And the pitch. And a half-hearted swing there as they tie him up. Here's Carlos Santana now. He'll try to get it going here to begin the fourth.
First baseman.
And that one's in on the hands to start the inning. It's ball one. And a strike to even the count. 1-1. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. And there's a pitch that just misses the inside corner. Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch. Here is a ground ball now for the shortstop to the right of second. Throw to first in time, one gone here in the fourth.
Now batting.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Tyler Naquin. He's 0 for 1 thus far. First pitch is a splitter for a called strike. Ready with the nothing and one pitch. That misses wide. One ball and one strike. Lays off the splitter that time, and it's two balls and a strike. Strike two at a pitch that catches the outside corner. Into the windup. Here comes the 2-2 pitch. Fastball, strike three called as he couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away.
Now batting, third baseman, Jose Ramirez.
This should end the inning as it's sent out to second. Scope has it. Throw on to Davis, takes care of him, and that'll end the inning. Here's Manny Machado now. Comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ballgame. Into the windup and the pitch. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. Throw just in time, and oh, that was awfully close. And it doesn't look like the manager fully agrees with that out call at first. It appears he may opt to challenge it and have the play reviewed.
Well, I think we're going to have to wait and see what the word is from the dugout, but here's another look at it. Wow, tough to tell if he was out for certain from that angle. I can see why this was a really tough call for the umpire.
So here's the signal from the bench, and they will indeed ask for the play to be reviewed. So the umpires will get on the horn with the replay operations center in Manhattan and attempt to get a definitive answer on this play.
The Orioles have elected to challenge the
All right, we'll
play.
Take one last look at it here. The question is there enough video evidence to change the call to safe? And wow, from that look at it, I think he did beat that throw. This challenge might work out for him.
The decision appears to have been made as the headset comes off, and the runner is safe. So the call is overturned. The runner will stay at first base, and they maintain the right to challenge further plays going forward. Here's Chris Davis now. In the dirt, and now let's see. And no advance, it's ball one. Swing and a miss. Little too anxious there, one and one. Davis waits on the 1-1. A swing and a miss at a ball down.
Good job of making him chase that pitch down below the strike zone. That's where you want to pitch when you're looking for the double play ball.
And they really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out.
Right fielder, Mark Trumbo.
Before the first pitch, a check at first. A dive, but he's back. First pitch coming. Here it is. Mark Trumbo swings and misses there, so he's down 0-1.
Here we are in the middle innings, Matt, and he's over 80% first pitch strikes on hitters. You wonder why he's dominating right now. That's a great ratio, getting ahead and getting them out.
And, boy, they're really giving him fits inside now as he can't get extended there, and it's 0-2 now. Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone.
How about it?
Digging in for his second at-bat, Hyunsoo Kim. He reached on a single in his first try. And he takes ball one. Ready with the 1-0 pitch. There's a bouncer foul to the left of the plate, 1-1. Here it comes on 1-1. Oh, they have him looking awfully confused up there right now. It's 1-2.
I'll tell you, if I'm on the hill, I'm throwing that changeup again. Didn't look like he picked it up very well out of his hand.
Runners on the move for second. And the inning. So striding forward now, Lonnie Chisenhall. He's in to get things going here in inning number five. And the first pitch is chopped foul at the plate at strike one. 0-1 is a splitter that misses for the first ball. And he'll come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now. Now the pitch. He's fallen behind now, 3-1.
Well, he falls behind 3-1 right now, but man, he is really throwing the ball well. He's been attacking them all game.
3-1 pitch is a slider, and he can't pull the trigger. It's 3-2 now. And a good eye here as he takes ball four, and it's a base on balls to lead off the fifth inning.
Now batting.
So stepping in. Yan Gomes. He'll try to follow up the double in his last at bat with another big hit right here. Ball one. One run, five hits. No errors to this point for the Indians. And maybe a little frustrated on the mound here as the fastball misses for ball two now.
Seems to me like they're pitching him a little bit more cautiously after that double he had his first time up.
Looks like a lefty and a right-hander throwing in the Baltimore bullpen. Good downward movement fooled him there. 2-1. And now this is popped up. Castillo should have room behind the plate. And he will make the catch here right in front of the screen. And that's your first out.
Now batting.
On its way is pitch number 75.
Michael Brantley.
Gets a good piece of it there, but this is foul off toward the third base coaching box. Out in front as this is pulled foul into the seats. And prior to the 0-2, we'll move to first. Runner back standing. Sent on the ground out to second. And Brantley will reach. He's got a base hit. Ready for another shot now. Francisco Lindor. It was an RBI single for him in his last plate appearance. And he'll miss the target away with the fastball. It's 1-0. And he misses low with it, 2-0. Ready with the 2-0 pitch. And this will be fouled away. Now the double steal is on here. Pitch swung on and missed the throw. Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch. And that's low, so a good eye there as he works the count back full. This is line to left. And that gets down as he can't get there in time. The tag from Castillo is not in time, and the run's in to score. Edwin Encarnacion now trying to keep things going now with a runner at first following the RBI single. There's a good fastball on the outside corner as he'll take a look at strike one. Comes set and the 0-1. And here's a ball lifted high into foul ground down the right field line. And he will get there to make the running play. And that. Here's the catcher, Wellington Castillo. He'll lead things off as we begin the home fifth. First pitch coming. Here it is. Off the plate and away there. One ball, no strikes. There's a high foul ball as it finds a lucky fan in the upper deck for a souvenir. Just lucky to make contact on that one as it's chopped foul. Here's the 1-2 delivery. And he wasn't going to hit that one with an or. The strikeout, and there's one gone.
Now batting.
Stepping in, Pedro Alvarez. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. And a hard sinker there. Chopped foul at home plate. Kluber gets the sign. Coming at him with the 0-1. Off the plate. One ball, one strike. 1-1, here it comes. Good sinker that time as he gets a piece and chops it foul at home plate.
Wow, he's cruising right now out there. Four straight punch outs and working on number five.
And another foul ball. Here's another 1-2. Boy, and they cannot touch him right now. Five straight strikeouts on the ledger, and there are two away.
Jonathan Schoop.
Here comes the first pitch. This is foul right side. The windup and the 0-1. Soft liner towards short. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. In is the second baseman, Jason Kipnis. No hits in two trips to the plate for him in the ballgame. Vidal Nuño takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound.
Now pitching for the Orioles, number 54, Vidal Nuño.
And he'll start the inning with a pitch that misses off the plate. It's ball one. And he looks at a curveball that falls in, 1-1. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Takes a fastball on the inside corner. Set to deal on a ball and two strikes. And that one stayed too low, apparently.
Well, that's what you want from your curveball on 1-2. You start it in the zone and let it break out of the zone where it can't be punished. Didn't get him to go after it, but the execution was nice.
Locked him up with the off-speed stuff on that one. Jason Kipnis goes down to become the first out in the sixth inning. And the off-balance throw beats him at first, and that's a tough play.
How about him? The center fielder.
Digging in to try it again, Tyler Naquin. Third trip to the plate for him here tonight. 0-2 at this point. And a called strike down in the zone. Nothing and one. Oh, got him to swing out of his shoes on that one. Nothing and two. Two quick strikes, and now the 0-2. A little bit off the outside. It's 1-2. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2.
Pretty standard curve in the dirt, looking for a strike out there, but that was a good job of recognizing it and holding back at the plate.
And this one's chopped foul right at home plate. Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. A swing and a miss on a ball way outside. Some stirring now in the Cleveland bullpen. They'll get both a left-hander and a right-hander up and throwing.
The shortstop.
First offering on its way.
J.J.
Hardy will stand in for the second time now as he looks at a called strike. It's nothing and one.
Well, this offense finds themselves struggling right now, and they're down a few runs. They've got to try to manufacture, get somebody on, maybe hit and run, and then you look for the big ball. Looks like right now everybody's swinging for the downs. They got to turn it around a little bit. Play a little small ball. Get it going.
But hold on here now. He jumped out of that dugout in a hurry. He might ask for that out call to be reviewed.
Yeah, definitely one of those bang-bang plays. And looking at it right here again, I still don't know if I can tell for sure. Going to be interesting to see what they decide to do here.
Here's the center fielder now, Adam Jones. As he'll take a look at a pitch too low, it's ball one. He's 0-2 in the ballgame so far. There's a cut fastball that time that runs in a bit too tight, and it's 2-0 now. Here's the 2-0 pitch now to Jones. And he swings on top of one here and chops it foul right at home plate. Gets the sign. Here comes the 2-1. Out into right center. Well hit. Jones around first, thinking two here. And he'll reach second now with one away. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Manny Machado. He singled in two trips to the plate thus far. Now some movement in the Tribe bullpen as a right-hander starts to loosen up. And this is taken outside for ball one. For Jones, a good start as he's got his first double of the year here on opening night. And this is fouled back and out of play. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. A good knee-high changeup taken for a strike. Kluber pauses. 1-2 on its way. And here's a ball lifted back toward the stands in right, so we'll try it again at 1-2. He'll try again, 1-2. Swing and a miss, and they'll dodge a major bullet that time. Two away.
First baseman, number
riding
19,
in once again, Chris Davis. He started out the evening 0-for-2 so far. Now he lifts a high pop-up, drifting into foul territory on the right side.
And that'll do it in the inning as the catch is made in the coach's box.
Ready for another shot now. Jose Ramirez. He'll be tasked with starting things as we begin the seventh.
Ramirez.
Into the windup and the pitch. Sends that one out of play for strike one. Here's the 0-1. Slow roller left side. And the throw to first is in time, so the leadoff man is gone here to start inning number seven.
The right fielder, number eight,
Lonnie Chisenhall, will stand in.
Chisenhall.
It was a walk in his last trip. And he starts the number eight hitter with a strike, nothing and one. Sent on the ground out to second. And the throw pulls the first baseman off the bag, and he's safe at first.
Now batting.
Here's the catcher, Yan Gomes. One for two with a double on the ledger so far. Now here's a slider that can't quite get back to the outside corner. It's ball one. And this is a fastball that's right on the black but ruled a ball. It's 2-0 now. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. And this had home run distance, but it just does hook foul. Two balls and a strike. Here it is. Took a wave at one around the shins with no luck. Even at two balls and two strikes, here's the pitch. Ran that one in on him a bit as this time it's tapped foul at home plate. And this is pulled foul as he was way out in front there.
Oh, he's clearly hitting off the fastball right there. You don't hit one that hard if you're not looking for it.
Ball three. 3-2 now. And he takes ball four. So a good job out of the nine hole in getting on base as we go back to the top of the order.
Michael Brantley.
And the slider swung on and chopped foul right at home plate. It's strike one.
Well, the Indians have been searching for that big hit pretty much all game. It remains to be seen if they can get it, but now sure would be a great time.
Nope. Tried to get him to go after one below the knees, but it's 1-2.
This is a big spot right here. Two runners on, and you knew he was going to waste a pitch right there, 0-2. But right now you can still make him chase out of the zone, and you got a chance to get out of this jam.
Again, a 1-2. And a swing and a ball hit foul heading for the seats. So another foul ball here, and it remains 1-2. And now a right-hander up and throwing in the Baltimore bullpen. Another 1-2 delivery. And a fastball. Tough take there, but it's even back at 2-2.
Well, one thing about him, he's an absolute grinder at the plate. You can pretty much count on him battling at the plate every chance he gets.
That was the fifth foul ball in this at bat. He's seen a lot of pitches.
But this is hauled in by the second baseman. So here's Francisco Lindor now. Couple of singles to his credit thus far.
Francisco Lindor.
Oliver Drake is out from the bullpen now as he'll make his first appearance here on the season.
Oliver Drake.
It's a swinging bunt up the line, but it gets foul. Two runs, seven hits, no errors to this point for the Indians. Fastball, whoa, look out. That just about got him in the coconut.
I'll tell you, there was intent behind that pitch. I'm not saying he was trying to hit him, but when you're facing a guy like this, you don't want him to get too comfortable in that batter's box.
To 2-2 now. Pulled high in the air out to right field. On the move is Crumbo, and the inning is over.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the traditional seventh inning stretch.
Here's Mark Crumbo now, 0-for-2 with a couple of strikeouts for him so far. right into the windup and the pitch. And this one's nowhere close as that bounces to the plate for ball one. Good swing, just got to try and straighten that one out. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Favorable call in there for a strike.
Tying run stands on deck, but it'll only matter if the guy in the box can get on base.
Yeah, and that has to be his mentality at the plate right now, Matt. He can't be the hero, so he needs to do what he can to give the guy behind him a chance to be the guy.
One thing you try to do as a hitter is figure out what pattern the pitcher is pitching. I can't cover the whole plate. He's done a masterful job of pounding him on the outside half for strikes, and they haven't figured it out yet.
So he gets him swinging on a pitcher's pitch. Mark Trumbo is sent packing to begin the bottom of the inning. Swing and a miss for strike one. Bases are empty, one man out. And this one's tapped foul at home plate. And he'll stay alive here as this is chopped foul at the plate. It'll remain one and two. Now a cutter down around his shoe tops as he hops out of the way.
Pretty sure there wasn't any ill will behind that pitch considering he has two strikes on him. Just got away from him from what I could tell.
Just staying alive, putting together a really good at bat here. The 2-2 one more time. Hit hard on the ground is short. Lindor is there. Throw gets him. Two down. Ready once again. Wellington Castillo. He's 0 for 2 with a strikeout in this one. Action going on now in the Indians bullpen as they have a left-hander up and getting loose. And a half-hearted swing there as he tried to go the other way, and it's strike one. Oh, he had him fooled there. No balls and two strikes.
Boy, he's been great in this one. He's only one strike away from putting another zero on the scoreboard.
Might have been looking to find that outside corner, but he couldn't quite get it there. It's one and two. Trying to send him packing for the second time. Takes this the other way to right. That gets down, and the inning continues. Digging in once again, Pedro Alvarez. He's 0 for 2 thus far in this one. From the belt, the pitch. First pitch is a sinker, too low, 1-0. 1-0 count, here it is. Hit out towards second. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. Now at the plate, Edwin Encarnacion. He'll start things out for us here in inning number eight. Brad Brock is out from the bullpen as he'll get his first work of the season here on opening night.
Number 35, Brad Brock.
On to the eighth now as the first pitch is a fastball that's looked at for ball one. Pitch on the way. Lays off a fastball that doesn't miss by much, and it's 2-0.
Well, 2-0 now, and this is where he makes his money. If he gets a pitch to hack at, you can bet he's not going to hold back.
He just took a fastball right down the middle, 2-0. He must have been sitting on a breaking pitch, because you don't take that unless you are.
Now a ball fouled down the right field line out of play, so that'll move the count to 2-2 now. Just got a piece of it as it's fouled back. Another try at 2-2. Look out. Don't want to hit him there. It's full 3-2.
Not sure if that was a purpose pitch or not, but I like it. As a pitcher, sometimes you've got to be willing to back the guy off the play fight. Running something hard inside. You can't just let guys be comfortable standing in the batter's box against him.
So he racks up the swinging strikeout on the breaking ball. Edwin Encarnacion goes down to become the first out in the eighth inning. Just does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul. Now a fastball as he has to lean out of the way there.
What makes hitting so difficult is covering both sides of the plate. And that hard pitch right there that was inside makes it awfully tough now to cover both the inside and the outside part of the plate.
Got him. And that's the third time we've written a K next to his name in this one.
Carlos.
I'll try to check his swing there as this is hit to the left side. Hardy over to his left. Throw on to Davis, takes care of him, and that'll end the inning. Ready for another chance? Jonathan Schoop. He'll see what he can do leading off the home eight.
Baseman, number six, Jonathan Schoop.
And that slider's almost in the dirt. Into his windup, here comes the 1-0. In tight with the sinker, ball two.
It's never advantageous to fall behind 2-0 as a pitcher, but if you're going to do it, it's far better to do it with a guy down in the bottom of the order. Time for a challenge fastball right here, though. Yeah, well, down two, you better believe they gladly take a leadoff walk right here. Anything to get a base runner on to get that tying run to the plate.
And this is taken here for ball four. So the leadoff man's on base to kick off the home eight. He's set and the pitch. J.J. Hardy is in for the third time here as he watches one that misses low. It's a ball and no strikes. And a strike to even the count. 1-1.
Well, he's done a real nice job with that breaking ball in this start. That's not the first time he's locked a guy up with it.
Little chopper back to the mound. And he won't even think about second as he'll flip on to first for the sure out. Trying to pick things up where he left off. Adam Jones. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. Kluber pauses. Here's the first pitch. Now a swing and a ball chopped foul right at home plate. 0-1. Here it comes. And this is sliced foul into the stands in right, out of play. Now a look and a throw back to second. But the runner's back easily. Looking to put him away. Here's the 0-2. A swing and a miss. He offered it a ball way outside the strike zone for out number two.
Number 13,
so
Manny
a pivotal
Machado.
Moment here and digging in now. Manny Machado. But a single here could reduce the deficit to only one. Hit to short. And that's through into left, a base hit. The throw home. But not in time as the run scores and the lead is trimmed to one.
First baseman,
so they'll go
19.
To the bullpen now, and it'll be the left-hander here to face the upcoming left-handed batter. Chris Davis will be his first assignment upon entering as he'll bat with the runner in scoring position here and two away. Trying to hold the lead, here's the delivery. And a whiff at a good slider that time. A one pitch on its way. Oh, and this at bat is quickly moving from bad to worse. It's 0-2 now.
Oh, that was a tough pitch to lay off. If he took this hack at that slider, he thought it was going to be over the plate and just kept running away.
And he'll get back in safely. Ready with the 0-2. He struck him out, and the tying run will be left. And next will be the versatile Tyler Naquin. 0-for-3 with a couple of strikeouts for him to this point in the ballgame. Ninth inning underway now as the first pitch is taken for a called strike. Movement in the Orioles' bullpen now as they've got a left-hander up and throwing. Late decision to swing that time, and as a result, it's 0-2. Good job of holding up on the low ball there, and it's 1-2. And 2-2. Here's the 2-2. Loop down towards short. And there's a base hit, and this could wind up as an important insurance strike here as the leadoff man's aboard to start the ninth. Into the box, Jose Ramirez. No hits in three tries so far. He struck out once. Inside with the first pitch splitter, and it's 1-0. 1-0 pitch on the way. A high fastball is in there. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Pitch misses low. The tag from Hardy, and they get him at second base. He's set, and the 2-1 pitch. Hit back up the middle. And that is through into center field for a one-out single. Lonnie Chisenhall will stand in.
Right fielder,
he singled earlier, making him one for two to this point.
Chisenhall.
Donnie Hart enters the game with one gone in the top of inning number nine.
Number 58, Donnie Hart.
Sharply hit ball back up the middle. And a great diving effort there, but it'll just tip off his glove, and it's a base hit. And a nice job to stay with it that time and get the second out of the inning. Here's the catcher, Yan Gomes. He doubled earlier in the game, one for two to this point.
Yan Gomes.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Good changeup that time, but he wouldn't bite on it.
You know, something to keep in mind, they're really burning through that bullpen, and this is only the first game of the series. Definitely could have an impact on the rest of the series, and maybe even the whole week ahead.
Here comes the 1-0. Out of play. Here it comes on 1-1. Takes a high fastball for a strike. Struck him out, so it remains a one-run lead as they head in for their final set of swings. Andrew Miller takes the ball now in inning number nine, looking to close the door. Here's Mark Trumbo now. Three at-bats for him in this one, all ending with him going down on strikes.
Number three.
Off the plate and away there. One ball, no strikes. Here it comes, 1-0 to Trumbo. Swung on and missed. Outclassed by that fastball for a strike. And he'll come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now. Pitch on the way. Hit sharply toward the right side. And it's a base hit. And just like that, the potential tying run is aboard here to start the home half of the ninth.
Now batting.
And that'll bring up the left-handed hitting outfielder, Hyun-Soo Kim. He'll be looking for something he could drive into the gap and drive home that tying run from first. Tries to catch him napping, but he missed the bunt attempt. Strike one. From the belt, the pitch. Now a bunt attempt here. A tag for one. And he's safe. Digging in and looking for more, Wellington Castillo. As he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Lifted in the air to shallow center field. Naquin will have plenty of room as he makes the catch, and there's a big out number two. In now is Pedro Alvarez. No hits in three tries so far. He struck out once. Thank you.
Joey Rickard will be called upon here to hit with the game on the line.
Number 23, Joey Rickard.
In there, 0-1. They'll go to work on getting that tying run home from second. And he swings and misses on that one, and now the Orioles are down to their final strike here.
Two things pitchers really love, called strike threes and jamming hitters. How about that? Talk about that jam right there. That's about as good as it gets.
Checked his swing there. Did he go around? No, says the first base umpire. Ball one. Has them down to their final strike. Here it comes. Struck him out, so he'll strand the possible tying run at second, and a great job of working out of trouble as this ball game is over. Well, we watched a really solid starting pitching performance, kept the opposition at bay, and as a result, he's our Topps player of the game.
Hey, when you go out there and punch out 11 hitters and you put your team in a great position to win a ball game, you deserve all of the recognition that comes your way.
Final line score for our ball game tonight for the victorious Cleveland Indians. 2 runs, 9 hits, no errors. They left 8 men on base. For the Orioles, 1 run on 6 hits. 1 error. They left 6 men on base. The winning pitcher is Corey Kluber. His record is now 1-0. Credit the save to Andrew Miller, his first. The loss goes to Kevin Gossman. He falls to 0-1. Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 42 minutes. Tonight's paid attendance here at the ballpark, 48,876. The Orioles would like to thank you for attending tonight's ball game and remind you to please drive home safely.
Almost ready for game time at Rogers Center as the roof is shut to keep us nice and warm. Tonight, an intriguing matchup between the Tampa Bay Rays and the Toronto Blue Jays. Blue Jays baseball starts right now. Malik Smith the next to hit. And we are set for baseball here this evening.
The designated hitter, number zero.
First pitch of the night here is taken for ball one as we are underway in Toronto. The windup and the 1-0 pitch. And he misses again, 2-0. Now here's the pitch. Chop foul over towards the dugout. Hitters count now. Here's the 2-1. Looking at a tough pitch, called a strike.
That is a filthy combination. High 90s with the fastball and then that nasty curveball. It's almost unhittable, almost unfair to the hitter.
Fastball didn't miss by much, and it's a full count now, 3-2. Now he gets on top of one here and chops it foul right at home plate. The 3-2 one more time. This one's flared out toward left. Herrera shading to his right, and he hauls it in for the first out of the inning. And here's the starting lineup for the visiting Tampa Bay Rays. Danny, any thoughts?
Well, Matt, Evan Longoria has been tearing it up lately. The guy is in the middle of the lineup, and when he's in the middle, things just happen. Guys in front of him get on, he drives them in, and if not, he has the ability to get things started and set the guys up behind him. He's a force.
Number three, Evan Longoria.
In is the third baseman, Evan Longoria. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Takes a look down at the knees for a strike. Clearly trying to control the running game with the slide step here.
Yeah, that's a good way of trying to control the running game, Matt. The problem with it, though, it has to...
Oh, and they've got him picked off. Thought about going for second, but instead, now they've got him in a pickle. And they'll run him down and tag him for the out. Just getting started at the Rogers Center. And Longoria swings right through that one as he's behind 0-2 now. Now here's the pitch. A little bouncer. That winds up foul. Now a fastball swung on and missed, and that is out number three. Nothing doing. And that'll bring up the speedy Devin Travis. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
Second baseman.
First pitch is a slider called for a strike. One strike now from Archer. Oh, and he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two. So back-to-back sliders for strikes. Does he come back with yet another?
Normally not a good pitching plan to throw the same hitter the same pitch three times in a row, but both of those sliders back-to-back were so good, I might just go ahead and try to throw another one.
In the dirt, but swung on and missed. And he makes the throw to first. Travis is retired, and there's one away. With that, let's take a look at the Blue Jays starting lineup. What's the key to sending fans home smiling tonight, Harold?
Matt, have you seen this guy throw? Ooh, he is electric. What do you got to do against him? I think you got to attack him early. He's just too overpowering. His stuff is electric. He's got one of those great power arms that we'll talk about for years to come. You got to take it to him before he takes it to you.
Late decision to swing that time, and as a result, it's 0-2.
Well, I think his eyes lit up when he saw that pitch coming up at his eye level.
Yeah, good luck. But hey, a high fastball all of a sudden becomes really dangerous for a pitcher if it's not spotted above the zone. A little height difference makes all the difference.
Infield single, as innocent as may sound, that might be a rally starter right there.
Jose Bautista.
Digging in now, Jose Bautista. First shot for him here with a runner at first now and one away. And a check swing looked like he went around. Yes, indeed, says the first base umpire. Strike one. The 0-1 pitch. And there's ball one.
Oh, he missed that pitch. I tell you what, as the pitcher, he's got to gain his composure. You can see guys fall apart if you see a ball in the zone that long to call a ball on.
And look out. He has to back away there and then give a little glare out to the mound. It's ball two. Pitch inside. The throw. In time as he just gets the tag down.
Well, so much for that first hit of the game. Tried to press their luck and move him up to second with the steal, but it didn't work out.
3-1 pitch is a slider, and he can't pull the trigger. It's 3-2 now. Archer steps into his windup. Here it comes on 3-2. Here's one that misses, and down to first goes Bautista. It's ball four. Here's Kendrys Morales. He takes his first cuts in this one with a man at first and two away. Drops in a strike to start the at-bat. Nothing and one.
Pretty lucky to get away with that one. There's not a situation ever where you want to throw a high changeup, so I think he'll try to make an adjustment with the next one he throws.
Now, Matt, that was a fastball. He had to have made up his mind that he's going to swing as soon as he releases it. That wasn't even a breaking pitch, and he was hacking.
And a classic 0-2 pitch as the changeup misses low, and it's 1-2 now. Hit hard down the left field line, but this is foul near the seats. Now another 1-2, and a neck-high fastball that time. Strike three called, and the inning is over. Standing in, Brad Miller. Head-to-head history with Aaron Sanchez. Not great, and he's 1-for-8. Swung on and missed that time. It's 0-1. The windup and the 0-1. Ground ball sent back up the middle. Backhanded. And the throw is wide as it pulls the first baseman off the bag.
Well, when you lead off an inning, you become the leadoff guy. Get on any way you can. And right there, that little infield single, as innocent as it might look, might start a rally for them. Do anything you can to get on.
Corey Dickerson stands in as he looks at a called strike. Set. Here's the 0-1. And this will ricochet off of him on the mound. Coming to the plate now, Steven Souza. And he could give his guys an early lead if he can come through here. Sacrifice attempt here. Goes to third with it, and they get the force over there for the first out. Throw across to first won't be in time, so he's aboard on the fielder's choice.
Batting seven.
Settling in now, Tim Beckham, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. Hit to short. And that's through into left, a base hit. Dickerson rounds the corner and is headed home. And not in time as the run scores. And on the play, the runner moves into scoring position now at second.
Batting eight. First baseman
into the box now, Logan Morrison. He's got a chance to add to this early lead as he'll bat with a couple of guys in scoring position. And a ball 1-0. Here comes the 1-0. Ball chop foul right at home plate, and that evens the count at 1-1.
Well, he fouled that breaking ball off a little bit early. Timing not quite there. Had a fastball to pitch before. He just got out in front of that breaking ball.
His pitch count is getting up there in the inning now. He needs to get this frame over with sooner than later, so forcing contact and getting the defense involved is probably the best thing he can do.
Runners are at second and third with one down. Got him swinging. Chased it well out of the zone, and there are two gone. Standing in, Kirk Casale. He'll get to take his first cuts here. First delivery to him on the way. First pitch here misses wide, 1-0. 1-0 pitch on the way. And this is going to be fouled into the diamond level seats. 1-1, here it is. Fouled off again, and now he's in a 1-2 hole. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. Runners at second and third with two gone. Here's a high pop-up. Smoke is there for it. Makes the catch, and that'll retire the side. So it's a run on three hits, no errors, and two men left on. Here's Troy Tulowitzki now. Head-to-head against Chris Archer. 2 for 11.
Troy Tulowitzki.
First pitch hacking here, and that's the first strike. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. And boy, they're really giving him fits inside now as he can't get extended there, and it's 0-2 now.
Well, that's a true indicator he's looking for a fastball in. He wanted to spin the wind right there and knock one as far as he could. He got the off-speed pitch inside, and he pulled off of it.
And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning.
All right, time for the majestic defensive alignment for the Rays. And I'm looking
Russell
at Corey
Martin.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Russell Martin is in with one away now as he swings and misses here at strike one. Bases are empty, one man out. And that's inside off the plate with the fastball. It's 1-1.
That's not an easy pitch to do anything with, right? 96 miles an hour in on the hands. You almost have to be looking for that pitch to be able to do anything with that.
Here's the 1-1 pitch. Fastball misses in the dirt as he tried to get him to chase the low one. The pitch. Swing and a miss. 2-2 now.
Boy, Matt, we're watching him have great success on that exploding fastball at the top of the zone. And I'm telling you right now, you can't catch up to that. It looks great to you coming in, but you have to get your bat in the position to get on top of it, and it's just too hard to do all those things and think you're going to square it up.
Full count now, 3-2.
I think if he executes that pitch on the corner instead of off of it, he probably gets some pretty weak contact, if anything. He jammed him pretty hard on the previous pitch, so my bet was he was going to try to cheat on the inside part, thinking it might be coming again.
Oh, and this is swung on and missed. Four strikeouts already, and that's out number two. Here's Justin Smoke now. first two men in the inning of both.
Justin Smoke.
Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch. Tough slider that just catches the corner for a strike. The windup and the 0-1. Here's a swing and a high pop-up. Morrison is there for it. He makes the play, and that'll end the inning. 1-2-3 go the Blue Jays. They're down 1-0. Digging in to try it again. Malik Smith, 0-for-1 for him here in this one.
Malik Smith.
Now he'll step off. First pitch on its way. And he just misses with a curveball.
Backdoor breaking ball just missed right there. It's such an effective pitch if you can hit the corner with it, but no dice this time.
Now a pitch swung on and grounded out to Tulowitzki at shortstop. Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third.
Now batting, center fielder.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Kevin Kiermaier. 0-for-1 here in the early going. And that's waved at and missed for strike one. That's in there, and he's deep in the hole now, 0-2. Into the windup, here comes the 0-2 pitch. And he'll try and tempt him with one in the dirt, but he'll hold back here. It's 1-2.
Hey, 0-2 pitch in the dirt, I think that was a purpose pitch. These guys are swinging at just about everything, so he's going to take a chance to see if they'll chase one even further out of the zone.
Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Pilar's there. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away.
The third baseman, number 3, Evan Longoria.
Striding in once again, Evan Longoria. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up. Hits the bottom of the strike zone here with the sinker. Strike one. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Swing and a miss just behind a lively fastball. And Dan, that's a pretty good example of why he's such a great pitcher.
Yeah, stuff. Stuff is obviously the important key to being dominant on the mound, but it doesn't mean.
And we'll have to leave it there as this is strike three, and that will retire the side. Stepping up to the plate, Kevin Pillar, head-to-head against Chris Archer, comes in with 6 hits in 28 tries. He's gone down on strikes 8 times as well. He's ready. Here's the 0-1. Swing and a flare hit toward right. Souza is over, and that's the first out of the inning.
Batting ninth.
Striding into the box, Ezekiel Carrera. Runs up to bunt here, but he missed it for strike one. And now a pitch on the way. Grounded up the first baseline, and he'll take it to the bag himself for the out.
Now batting. Second baseman.
Ready for another chance? Devin Travis. He was a strikeout victim in his first try. That's it to short. Does he have another 1-2-3 inning? He does. 7 in a row he set down now as the side is retired. Blue Jays go down in order. They trail this one 1-0. In now, Brad Miller. He'll be the one to lead things off now against Aaron Sanchez.
Brad Miller.
A fastball, and he swings through it to fall behind. Here's the 0-1 pitch. Grounded back up the middle. Throw to first in time. One gone here in the fourth.
The left fielder, number 10.
Digging in, Corey Dickerson. sends that one out of play for strike one. Here comes the 0-1. Hard hit to first. Smoke takes it in. And he'll step on first himself for the out.
The batter, right fielder.
Digging in for his second at bat, Steven Souza. He's 0-for-1 thus far. And a fastball's off the plate away. It's ball one. One run on three hits. And no errors for Tampa Bay so far. And that pitch misses in the dirt, and it's 2-0 now.
Well, that pitch wasn't even close. And now that was an easy take. Now he's locked in. You're sitting there 2-0. Get real specific. Make him throw you your pitch.
I got 2-1 to count.
Swung on. Missed. 2-1. Slow bouncer to the right side. But that one rolls foul. Two out, nobody on. Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. Here's the third baseman, Josh Donaldson. He'll stand in against Chris Archer to get the inning underway.
Donaldson.
Over towards the dugout, but this one will get into the stands. And this one's chopped foul right at home plate.
Well, he's out in front of that changeup. I think, Matt, that was a result of the fastball, the pitch before. He's throwing so hard, you got to honor that fastball in that situation. He's just fouling him off till he gets something he wants to hit.
The windup and the 0-2 pitch. At third, Longoria fielded cleanly. Throw on to first, and one third baseman grounds out to the other, one away.
All right, fielder number 19.
Now in the box, Jose Bautista reached base via the walk in his first plate appearance. Called a strike on the outer half, 0-1.
I'm sitting here shaking my head. I'm tripping, man. I mean, I've never watched a guy throw this many strikes. First pitch strike, he's 100% in the game. Every batter, first pitch or strike.
Oh, man, he just tied him up in knots right there.
And a swing and a miss as they got him with the slider there, two away.
The batter,
here's Kendrys Morales. Comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. Ready to deliver, here's the first pitch. Took a wave at one around the shins with no luck.
That's exactly what you don't want to do first pitch. If you're going to swing first pitch, you want to drive it. You can't take an ugly, bad swing on the first pitch when you know what you're looking for. You got to be more patient because you're going to get more pitches.
Looking to put him away, here's the 0-2. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. On to Morrison at first, and that ends the inning. Nothing doing. Now at the plate, Tim Beckham.
Leading
he'll start things out as we begin the
shortstop,
fifth.
Tim Beckham.
Yeah. And this pitch is taken on the inner half for strike one. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. A fastball right over the outside corner.
He's really put himself now in a position where he's got to battle. Took the first two strikes, didn't swing, and now you just grind out the AB.
And he'll try and tempt him with one in the dirt, but he'll hold back here. It's 1-2. Now a curveball stays inside. Two balls and two strikes.
Man, this at-bat has changed quickly from 0-2 now to 2-2. A good job of plate discipline by this hitter, not chasing those pitches just off the plate.
Got him swinging on the fastball there. Tim Beckham is retired
seven
to kick off the inning.
Logan Morrison.
First offering on its way. Logan Morrison stands in as he swings and misses for strike one. The windup and the 0-1. There's that heavy sinker for strike number two.
Clearly wasn't ready for the fastball because it was pretty much center cut and he couldn't pull the trigger. Might have been looking for another curve.
And he struck him out. Second time tonight now that he's been set down on strikes.
Now batting. Catcher.
Digging in. Kurt Casale. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. The fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one. 1-0. into his windup. Here comes the 1-0. And that swung on and fouled straight back. One run on three hits, and no errors for Tampa Bay so far. Push softly over toward the right side. He lays out, but he can't make the play, and it's through into right.
Now
Malik Smith, the next to hit. He started out the evening 0 for 2 so far. Now a bunt attempt here. This gets foul. It's 0-1. Two out with the man at first. Now a check swing, but he holds up in time. Ball one.
Well, you're in trouble at the plate if you fall behind this guy 0-2, so that was a good job to hold up right there.
Just does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul. Ready to deliver the 1-2. Started the chase there. They'll appeal it down to third, and no swing. It's ball two. He's ready with the 2-2 pitch. Chopped down the first baseline, but it's a foul ball, says the first base umpire. Another try at 2-2. He's on the move again from first. And here's a ball hit in the air. And this will land foul. Seventh pitch of the at-bat coming up. Swing and a little blooper to center. Alar moving in. He's there to make the play, and that'll retire the side. After the break, don't go away. Troy Tulowitzki will start things off. It's the Rays 1, the Jays nothing. Here's Troy Tulowitzki now. He's 0 for 1 thus far. First pitch coming. Here it is. This ball's hit in the air down the right side and out of play. 0-1. And Tulowitzki can't come up with that one as he falls behind 0-2 now. Looking to punch him out again, the pitch. And he struck him out. Russell Martin now comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ballgame.
Russell Martin.
Looking at a fastball for a strike on the corner.
Well, he got a high strike on a fastball right there. That's pretty unusual. Usually early in the count, you're going to see a guy work down in the zone. That high fastball usually the put-away pitch with two strikes. He pitched him backwards right here.
I got to say, his command of the corners in this start has been pretty exceptional. He's mixed east and west really well, and it's a big reason why he's had success.
Got him to miss the breaking ball there. Russell Martin becomes out number two this inning.
First baseman.
Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch. Ball chopped foul right at home plate, and it's 0-1. Bases are empty here with two men out. On, could we see another strikeout here? It's 0-2 now.
And there's number 8, one away.
And he struck him out, his 8th punch out of the ballgame, and that one ends the inning. Standing in, Kevin Kiermaier.
Leading
he's 0 for 2
Bay.
Thus far in this
center
one.
Fielder, Kevin Kiermaier.
And this ball's going to find the seats down the left field line. Foul, strike one. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. And a pitch in the dirt as he lays off. It's 1-1. Now the pitch. Flipped out the other way towards short. But there to take it in is Tulowitzki, and that's the first out of the inning.
Number 3, Evan Longoria.
In is the third baseman, Evan Longoria. And he's likely just trying to put one in play here. 0 for 2 with a pair of strikeouts thus far. A swing and a miss on a ball that jammed him. The 0-1 pitch. Line to the right side.
Well, he persevered right through it. Now he's 0 for 2 before this base hit right here with two strikeouts. Man, this makes it feel good now. Now he's getting that confidence and a little swagger back.
Stepping in now, Brad Miller. As the first pitch to him is swung on and missed for strike one. A hit in two at-bats for him at this point in the ballgame. 0-1 count. Here's the pitch. And there's a pitch that just misses the inside corner.
That pitch right there, he's trying to keep him from getting his arms extended. If it's out over the plate more, he can obviously do a lot of damage with it.
Not trying to pick up that outside corner, but this misses, and it's back to even at two balls and two strikes. And here's a good sinker now, but it misses. 3-2.
Hey, not a bad time right here to put that runner in motion. 3-2 count. You send the runner, and if it's a bad pitch, it's ball four.
Now this ball is popped up behind the plate for Martin. And he'll stay with it to put it away as they get their man here for the second out. Ready for another chance? Corey Dickerson. One for two on his line so far in the game. Late that time for a strike. A runner on first with two away. Here's a look over to first. And he is tagged out here. Boy, a bad mistake that time. Digging in to try it again. Kevin Pillar. 0 for 1 for him here in this one.
Kevin Pillar.
Lofted in the air out toward right center. Souza is under it. One down.
The left fielder, number three.
Stepping into the box, Ezequiel Carrera. He's 0 for 1 thus far. Now a slider, and he gets ahead of him here, 0-1.
You know, when a guy starts to get tired, you often see their breaking stuff start to flatten out, but that's not the case here. Still has really nice finish on that slider, as we just saw.
The windup and the 0-2 pitch. Oh, and he's really got the strikeout pitch working now as he notches number 9 in the ball game.
Now batting.
Ready once again, Devin Travis. He comes in 0 for 2 thus far. Swinging a soft liner, and this is taken for the out. 1-2-3, go. Ready for another shot now, Corey Dickerson. He's singled and two trips to the plate thus far.
Corey Dickerson.
And a sinker misses here. No, a called strike. I take that back. The windup and the 0-1. Swing and a miss just behind a lively fastball.
I think a big reason why he's been so effective in this one, that he's been just about getting ahead of every hitter. Seems like every one of them are 0-2, 1-2, and it's just about every at bat. And when that's the case, your chances of getting a good pitch to hit are way worse.
And he checked his swing, but it's a strike three called, and that's the first out of the inning.
Now batting.
Riding in once again, Steven Souza. Third trip to the plate for him here tonight. 0 for 2 at this point. Way behind that pitch. It's 0-1. One out, nobody on. Slow curveball, like a balloon, and he couldn't hold back. It's strike two.
Now that's a good curveball. That's the old 12 to 6 from midnight to 6 a.m., and he's doing it all day.
And he struck him out, and that's 8 strikeouts thus far.
That's back-to-back punch-outs, and he's really starting to rack them up now, guys. I've got 8 strikeouts in my scorebook for him now, so he's got good stuff.
Swing and a liner, but foul. The 0-1 on its way. Off the plate, one ball, one strike. And did he go around? No, he did not. Ball two. Two out, nobody on. Squared that one up just a little late. Even at two balls and two strikes, here's the pitch. Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. Carrera's there. He makes the play, and that'll end the inning. Down in order go the Rays. But they're on top 1-0. Now to the plate, Josh Donaldson. He's
for
one
Toronto,
for two in the ballgame.
Third baseman.
Into the windup and
Donaldson.
The pitch. Pitch swung on and hit in the air. Kiermaier giving chase. And he hauls it in for the first out of the inning.
All right, fielder number 19.
Here comes the right fielder, Jose Bautista. Comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ballgame. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Chopper foul. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-1. Changeup gets him out in front for strike two.
The seventh inning is one of those innings when you might start seeing some warning signs from your starters that they're reaching the end of their rope, but that's not the case here. He looks really solid to me.
And indeed, the throw will finish him off as they get the put out at first, and there are two away now.
You know, professional catchers make those plays look easy most of the time, but that was a big play that shouldn't go unnoticed. Had he found a way on, he would have represented a tying run, so that was a nice job there to make sure that strikeout didn't get wasted.
Standing in now, Kendrys Morales, as he'll look at a slider that runs in too far for ball one. 0 for 2 for him to this point. There's a bouncer foul to the left of the plate, 1-1.
Tell you what, his spot has been the outside pitch right there, and now we're late in the game and he continues to pound the outside pitch, and it's really working out for him.
And now a fastball, but he's able to hold off on it, and it's 2-1 now.
He's obviously been very impressive on the mound in this one, and I think the big reason why is his ability to stay out of the middle of the zone. That's kind of obvious, but it's clear to me that even when he misses his spots, he's not missing over the plate. Boy, he's been great in this one, and he's only one strike away from putting another zero on the scoreboard.
Again, he sends it out of play. The 2-2 one more time. And yet another strikeout here. His 11th of the ballgame, and this one ends. Stepping up now, Logan Morrison. He's hoping to avoid the hat trick. He struck out in each of his first two plate appearances so far. Weak roller right side. And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out.
Now batting, catcher.
Digging in and looking for more, Kurt Casale, a hit in two tries so far. And he'll just fight this one off as it's chopped foul. That's taken. Now it's 0-2.
He's feeling it out there on the mound, just getting the ball and throwing it with a lot of confidence right now.
Into the windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Now a hard liner towards short, but unfortunately right after shortstop for the second out.
Now batting, designated hitter.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Malik Smith. He flew out in his last at-bat. This one's down to third. Donaldson's there. Throw on to smoke at first, and the side is retired. So they breathe. So coming to the plate, Troy Tulowitzki struck out twice thus far, so we'll see if he can fare any better here. Third baseman hugging the line here, now the first pitch. Just off the outside, and it's 1-0. Into his windup, here comes the 1-0. Good swing, just got to try and straighten that one out. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Fouled straight back. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. Struck him out. Struck him out again, I should say. His third punch out of the game.
The catcher, number 55.
Digging in once again, Russell Martin. Been a strikeout victim twice in this one. Dribbled to the right side. That's a foul ball. The 0-1 home to Martin.
Swings through it for strike number two.
The discipline has just been completely absent from this offense. Seems like they're always finding themselves behind the count, and a big reason why is they're swinging at all kinds of stuff that's not even in the strike zone.
And he struck out again. That's the third time he's gone down on strikes in this one. Here's Justin Smoke now. He's 0 for 2 with a strikeout in this one.
Justin Smoke.
Easy fly ball into shallow center field. Dickerson on the move. He makes the play. A great. Back at Rogers Center as we get a look at the great city of Toronto from the ferry on Lake Ontario.
Leading off for Tampa
into
Bay.
The windup and center the pitch.
Kevin Kiermaier.
Hit on the ground out to short. Tulowitzki has it. Throw on to first for the out, and that is how the ninth inning gets underway.
The third baseman, number 3, Evan Longoria.
In is the third baseman, Evan Longoria. He steps in off a base hit in his last at-bat. Swing and a miss that time. It's 0-1.
Well, he's throwing over 70% first-pitch strikes to all the hitters in the game right now. That's why he's pitching late in the game. He's getting ahead of guys, and then you can manipulate as you move forward.
And that's in for his second hit of the afternoon.
It sounds so cliche. It's stayed inside the baseball, but that's a ball in on him, and he just shot it the other way for the base hit.
Brad Miller.
In now, Brad Miller. As he'll go after the first pitch to him and comes up empty, it's strike one. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Here comes the 0-1. Slowly hit to first. I don't think they can get two. Tulowitzki for one. But wisely, no thought of a return throw, and the inning will continue.
The left fielder, number 10.
Corey Dickerson. He's got a hit in 3 at-bats to this point. There's a swing, and he sends a ball high in the air into left field. Herrera ranging back. But he has no chance to make the play. It's off the wall. And this will not be close, and the run will score easily.
Well, that base hit right there gives him 2-run cushion. When you have a 2-run cushion late in the game, you got to feel pretty good about yourself.
Roberto Osuna takes over now with 2 gone here in the top of inning number 9.
Number 54, Roberto Osuna.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Steven Souza is in with 2 away now as he looks at a called strike 1.
I don't have a problem taking that pitch right there. New pitcher just came in out of the bullpen. You want to see what he's got. You measured the first pitch. Now get ready to hit.
Gets the fastball by him here, and he's in control 0-2.
You know, it's so hard to get around on a pitch like that, particularly when it's up and in on your hands like that. I call that Black and Decker ball. It's going to break a lot of bats.
And a check swing. Did he go around? No, says the first base umpire. It's ball 1. And this swing is wrapped out to Tulowitzki at short. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. A run for the Rays thanks to the RBI double. One last shot for the Jays coming up, and it's 2-0 Tampa Bay. Into the box, Kevin Pillar. He'll lead things off here as we play the bottom of the ninth. Grounded to short. To his right, Beckham. Throw just does beat him to the bag, as that was pretty close.
Now batting.
Digging in, Ezekiel Carrera. He started out the evening 0 for 2 so far. Now a swing and a miss. Took something off that one, and it's strike 1.
Matt, this is getting a little ridiculous. That strike right there puts him at 90% of hitters he's throwing first pitch strike to. You do that, you're going to dominate lineups.
A windup and the 0-2 pitch. Struck him out and make it 14 punchouts now in the game. And that'll bring up the speed.
Second baseman, Devin.
Archer steps into his windup. First pitch on its way. And a feeble swing that time. It's 0-1.
Boy, that's an ugly swing right there. And they haven't been getting on base. They're not doing much of anything right now. Now, I tell you what, they got to figure out something to make an adjustment, or this game could get ugly quick.
has them down to their final strike. Here it comes. Swing and he pops him up over toward foul territory. Casale has a play, makes the catch, and that's the ball game.
Oh, man. So close, but yet so far. Can you imagine giving up one hit, pitching such good baseball for nine innings, but one base hit kept him from baseball history?
For our ball game tonight, for the victorious Ray, two runs, seven hits.
We are under the bright lights tonight as MLB Network welcomes you to this presentation of Major. Coming to you from Seattle tonight, where the roof at Safeco Field has been closed for comfort. Coming up, we've got a good matchup in store between the Baltimore Orioles and the Seattle Mariners. Looking forward to this matchup, and it's next on MLB Network. Adam Jones is in to start things out as he swings and misses at that one at strike one. And the recovery won't be in time as he'll beat the throw to first.
Batting second.
Here's Manny Machado now.
13, Manny
now
Machado.
A slider, and he gets ahead of him here 0-1. Check by Hernandez. The pitch. And he'll just get a piece here as this is chopped foul at home plate. And this one gets away. And forget about the double play now as he'll move up to second here on the wild pitch.
Designated hitter.
He's set and the
Mark
pitch.
Trumbo.
And they start him with a changeup, but this is chopped foul at home plate. Goodness. 0-2 now.
Now that's what a slider's supposed to look like. Great execution. Starts off the plate.
It's a high fly ball headed for the left field corner. If it stays fair, it's gone. And this had home run distance, but it just does hook foul. Oh, and he dusted him off the plate that time. Some mind games being played now. It's 1-2. To two balls and two strikes now. He's set. Here's the 2-2. Hit hard on the ground to the right. And that's through into right field for a base hit. And he'll get in there safely. Standing in now with runners in scoring position, Chris Davis. And he could give his guys an early lead if he can come through here. In the dirt and block behind the plate. Good job to corral this quickly as the runners hold on. Swing and a line drive. But this is foul near the seats. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. And another foul ball. Another 0-2 coming. Another one sent foul.
Well, that's three foul balls in a row. He's definitely battling up there.
He got him. And it'll probably take a base hit now to get that runner across from third.
The left fielder, number 25.
Comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Sends that one out of play for strike one. Here's the 0-1. And there's one well above the zone for a ball. Trying to hang a zero. Here's the pitch. And he pulled up in time, but it's a called strike two. Set to deal on a ball and two strikes. Swing and a little tapper. But that one rolls foul. Here he comes again. 1-2. Here's a curveball blocked by Zunino. And a nice job to keep the runners at bay as the count moves to 2-2. Softly hit here to the left side. But little trouble handling this one down there. Here's Jerod Dyson. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half
leading
of the first.
For the Mariners. Left fielder, Jerod Dyson.
Grounded softly to the right. Throw beats him by a half a step. He almost beat that out. Gene Segura standing in.
The shortstop.
First delivery to him on the way. Hard ground ball to third. Machado is there. Throw to first will be in plenty of time, and Jimenez is looking sharp now. Two away.
Batting third.
Here comes the second baseman, Robinson Cano. His past meetings against Ubaldo Jimenez. 9 base hits in 17 at-bats. He's also hit a couple of home runs against him.
Well, he got ahead of him right there, and I'd even say he got away with one. Down and in to this guy, that's his nitro zone right there. You don't want to float around there very often.
That's a good take on that fastball there. You know he's looking for something up there to drive, but that was just a little above his happy zone. Not everyone has the discipline to hold back on those.
Curveball locks him up, strike three, and that's... Here's Jonathan Schoop now. He'll be the first to greet Felix Hernandez to start the inning.
Jonathan Schoop.
Swinging a ball hit on the ground. This gets foul. It's 0-1. Chopped weakly to the left. Seager comes up with it. Throw to first will be in time, and there's one gone here to start the second. Here's the catcher, Wellington Castillo.
Wellington
Castillo. Into the windup and the pitch. And he's in front of a tight little slider that time. And this is sliced foul into the stands in right, out of play. Bases are empty, one man out. Again, he sends it out of play.
That is too good a pitch to make right there with two strikes. But he fouled it off. Now you got to stay aggressive and go get him again.
Breaking ball, and he gets him to chase it in the dirt. He makes the throw to first. Two down. Batting Here's in. The shortstop now, J.J. Hardy. The head-to-head history Hardy. With King Felix. Just a 3-for-13 batting line. He's also been a strikeout victim six times. The windup and the 0-1. Way in front of a great slider that time.
He's not messing around this inning. He's attacking the zone. He's showing lots of confidence.
Looking at a fastball to in. In now, Nelson Cruz. He'll be the one to lead it Leading off against Ubaldo Jimenez.
Designated hitter, Nelson Cruz.
Very weakly on the ground. Throw not in time to get him, and how about that? An unlikely infield single.
Batting fifth.
Here's the third baseman now, Kyle Seager. On a rope to the second baseman, but the runner is back to avoid the double play. So coming to the plate, Mike Zunino. First swings for him in this one, with a runner still at first and one gone. And they start him out away with a called strike. No, and he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two.
Good job of making him chase that pitch down below the strike zone. That's where you want to pitch when you're looking for the double play ball.
And he looks at a ball, 1-2. Jimenez deals the 1-2. And, oh, this one's by him to the backstop. And forget about the double play now, as he'll move up to second here on the wild pitch. He's set. Here's the 2-2. Here's a swing and a high pop-up drifting toward the third base dugout. And he'll stay with it to put it away as they get their man here for the second out. Striding into the box, Dan Vogelbach. Opportunity for him here to pick up that runner from second with two away. First pitch hack in here, and that's the first strike. From the stretch. And a fastball way off target here, and it's even at one. Ready with the 1-1 pitch. Kim is there, and he has it for the out. That'll bring in Joey Rickard. And he'll start out there half of the third, top of the order to follow. Now Hernandez will get back to work here as he jumps ahead of the leadoff man. No balls and a strike.
Well, he doubled up on that slider, so that tells me he's really feeling it at this point in the game. Good chance we'll see a heavy dose of that slider as this start continues.
And this is swung on and missed. Five quick strikeouts now, and that's your first out of the inning.
Now batting number 10.
First offering on its way. Adam Jones comes on with one gone here as he looks at a called strike one. Squared that one up just a little late. The windup and the 0-2 pitch. Here's a high pop-up. And he'll stay with it to put it away as they get their man here for the second out.
The third baseman, number 13.
Riding in once again, Manny Machado. 0-for-1 here in the early going. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. But he just missed his extra bases.
Look, Matt, he's done a nice job getting those first two outs. I mean, look, this is a good hitting team. And now you got the two-hitter coming to the middle of the order. But you can limit the damage by getting those first two outs. I think he's limited the damage.
A swing and a miss. That retires the... Stepping into the box, Mitch Haniger.
Leading
He'll get us
Mariner.
Going in the home half of inning
right
number three.
Fielder, Mitch. Haniger.
Back at it now is Jimenez, as he's able to jump ahead in the count quickly here. Nothing in one. Pitch on the way. Throw to first by Hardy for out number one. Here's Leonis Martin. His past meetings against Ubaldo Jimenez. Just a 2-for-14 line to show for it. He's taken him deep once. Sent toward first. He lays out for it, but he can't pull it in.
Now batting, Jerrod Dyson.
Now batting,
0 for 1 for him here in this one.
Jerrod Dyson.
From the stretch. Over toward the dugout, but this one will get into the stands.
This is the situation where there's a lot of pressure on the infielders if the ball is put in play on the ground. Both the guy at first and at the plate are burners, so a double play is going to be tough. Even getting one out could be a challenge.
Swing and a looper to left. In comes Kim. Two down. And he will scurry back to first as he'll think twice about trying to move up. Ready for another chance? Gene Segura. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. This ball's hit in the air down the right side and out of play. 0-1. Here comes the 0-1. Hit down the third baseline. But this will be a foul ball as he's behind 0-2 now. Jimenez ready with the 0-2. Pitch outside. The throw. Bottom of inning number 3. 0-0 our score. Here's a fastball in on the fist, and that'll even things up at 2-2. Now a swing and a bouncing ball for the shortstop, Hardy. Throw on to Davis, takes care of him, and that'll end the inning. Digging in to try it again, Mark Trumbo. He'll look to get something going here in this scoreless ball game. Hit hard towards center, and Trumbo will reach. He's got a base hit. So the fourth inning opens with a leadoff single. Here's Chris Davis now. He's 0 for 1 thus far. And that one swung on and missed 0-1. Still all zeros in the run column here in the fourth inning. Dan, does this continue or does somebody score here?
I think this continues for a while, Matt. Both of these pitchers are throwing very well, throwing strikes, having good command of their off-speed pitches. This is going to be one of those low-scoring affairs.
Got him to miss the breaking ball there. Chris Davis goes down to become the first out here in the fourth. And he swings on top of one here and chops it foul right at home plate. Fouled toward the third base dugout, but this will get back into the seats out of play.
He's just fouling them off till he gets something he wants to hit.
And this ball's chopped foul at the plate, and that'll hold the count at 0-2. And boy, what a battle brewing here as he fouls yet another pitch into the seats. Still stuck on 0-2.
I like that combination right there. Show him the curveball, and now that fastball sitting in the low 90s is going to look even faster. Nice job of mixing it up.
The second baseman, number 6.
First pitch of the at bat. Ooh, and Hernandez really overthrows this one. That'll be a wild pitch. So now two men in scoring position. Pitching has the upper hand early as we're scoreless in inning number 4. Well, they miss with the first one, but then they decide, let's go ahead and just put him aboard here, and they'll do just that.
Wellington.
Now he gets on top of one here and chops it foul right at home plate. A one pitch on its way. Another one fouled off, and he's quickly behind 0-2. Here's Hernandez now on 0-2. A swing and a miss for out number 2, and a ball he had no chance of making contact with. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Dribbled up the line. Foul ball, however, strike 1. On its way, the 0-1 pitch. A little tapper. Throw on to first is going to be in time, and the Oriole threat goes. Here's Robbie Cano now. Comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ball game.
Second baseman Robinson.
This is pulled into right. And a base hit. So he goes after the first pitch he sees, and he's on to open up the inning. Here's Nelson Cruz now.
Designated hitter. Nelson
ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Off the plate and away there. One ball, no strikes. 1-1.
Now, a mid-90s fastball is no joke, and that's proof right there. He threw it right by him.
Swing and a miss as he pulled the string on him, 1-2. Jimenez deals the 1-2. Well hit, but also well fouled into the seats and left. Both clubs with 3 hits in the ballgame. Ball 2. Yep. line toward center field. Jones, patrolling center, makes the play, one out.
And he will scurry back to first as he'll think twice about trying to move up.
Third baseman number 15.
Here's the third baseman now, Kyle Seager. 0 for 1 for him here in this one. Swung right over the splitter there, 0-1. Clearly trying to control the running game with the slide step here.
Yeah, that's a good way.
There's a swing, and he sends a ball high in the air into left field. Kim going back. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out. Here now is Mike Zunino, 0-for-1 after a pop-out in foul territory his first time through. Now a ball hit to center field and deep. Back goes the center fielder way back, and that ball is gone. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Ken Vogelbach hit it hard but lined out in his first at-bat. Way out in front. Right at the third baseman, and that'll end the inning. Digging in for his second at bat, Joey Rickard. He'll start things out as we begin the fifth.
Right fielder, Joey Rickard.
Lined but speared on a hop. And a close play at first, but a great stretch that time as they get him by a step for out number one. Here's the center fielder now, Adam Jones. A hit in two tries so far. Now a swing and a ball chop foul right at home plate. And Jones fails to come up with that one as he falls behind here, 0-2 now.
They can't afford to continue to fall back any further. They got to get something going on the offensive side. Somebody's got to step up, give a big hit, maybe even a home run, drop a bunt, do something. But this offense has to get going.
Struck him out, and he becomes the ninth strikeout victim thus far.
Manny
Machado is at the plate now, and he's quickly behind 0-1. Machado now on 0-1. And here's a swing and a miss as he falls behind, nothing and two.
Two outs, two strikes, and we're in the fifth inning, and he's got one hit.
And we'll have to leave it there as this is. Now to the plate, Mitch Haniger. He'll start things out in the home half of inning number five.
Right fielder, Mitch Haniger.
Jones is there, and he makes the catch for the out. Here's Leonis Martin, a base hit in his first trip.
Martin.
Oh, he chased a bad pitch that time. It's strike one.
His pitch count is in a really good place at this point of the game. He's pounding the zone and getting first pitch outs just like he did on the last guy. We might see him work deep into this game if he keeps this up. I got to say, his command of the corners in this start has been pretty exceptional. He's mixed east and west really well, and it's a big reason why he's had success.
Well, he's clearly in protect mode, 0-2. Good job of holding up right there.
To two balls and two strikes now. Soft liner to the right side, and that'll find its way into right field for a one-out single. Number nine batter comes through that time as it'll now be up to the top of the order with one away. Here's Gerard Dyson, 0-for-2 on his line thus far. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Kim will range to his left as he tracks this one down in left center for the second out of the inning. Gene Segura standing in. He's 0-for-2 thus far in this one.
Gene Segura
starts things with a splitter outside for ball one. Had him lunging at that pitch away, and it's 1-1 now. Checks his swing here, but he does so in time. Now a move over to first, and a dive, but he's back in there. Gets the sign. Here comes the 2-1. Takes a knee-high fastball. Throw over to the bag, and he has to dive, but he's back in easily. hit hard back up the middle. And that's through for his first base hit in this one. Here comes the second baseman, Robinson Cano. And we'll see what he can do here with a pair of runners on base and two gone here in the fifth. Good swing, just got to try and straighten that one out. Looking to wiggle out of this, here it is. Pulls this one into the air out into right field. Rickards under it. No trouble with this one, and the inning is over. Here's Mark Trumbo now. Couple of singles to his credit thus far.
Designated hitter.
Fastball in there for a called strike.
Here we are in the middle of the game, and he's 90% on the first pitch strike, throwing strikes. 90%. Forget about it. You do that, you got no chance of hitting this guy.
Oh, and he misses it. And he's going to get to second now with nobody out. Here's Chris Davis now. And he's likely just trying to put one in play here. 0-for-2 with a pair of strikeouts thus far. Just a bit jumpy that time. Swung on and missed.
This is going to be an interesting at bat. I think he has to be pitching for a strikeout here. So we'll see what kind of sequence he uses.
Throw on to first by Cano, and there's the first out of the inning. And that'll bring up the left-handed hitting outfielder, Hyung-Soo Kim. It's been an 0-for-2 effort for him to this point. Liner towards second. Throw to first is in time, but meanwhile, the runner is in to score.
The second base.
Striding in once again, Jonathan Schoop. He'll try and start things over now with the bases empty and two away following the RBI ground ball. And this is pulled foul as he was way out in front there. Next pitch for Felix will be number 75 in the ballgame. And yet another strikeout here. His stepping in and ready for another shot, Nelson Cruz. He's 1-for-2 in the ballgame.
Designated hitter, Nelson.
And he takes ball one. Well, he's having a good amount of success here, Dan, even though he hasn't really gotten a ton of swings and misses.
Yeah, it amazes me how every game you pitch can be so different, Matt. Sometimes it feels like guys can't touch you and you're just punching everyone out. But other times, you don't have your good stuff and you really rely on movement and location to get outs. That's been the case for him today, and it's really working.
2-2. Into the windup. Here comes the 2-2 pitch. And that one never threatened the zone. It's gone full now to 3-2. No walks so far. Here's the 3-2. And a base hit, so the leadoff man is on to begin the inning. Digging in once again, Kyle Seager. Third trip to the plate for him here tonight. 0-for-2 at this point. First pitch coming, here it is. Hit down the line at first. Fielded cleanly by Davis. And the good toss to Jimenez will be in time to get him at first. Ready for another shot now. Mike Zunino. He comes in 1-for-2 with that home run he hit earlier. Fouled back. Pitch on its way now to Zunino. Swung on and missed, outclassed by that fastball for a strike. Jimenez ready with the 0-2. And a check swing. Did he go around? No, says the first base umpire. It's ball one. The 1-2 pitch. Tried to hold up there. Appeal down to first and no swing. It's ball two. He's set. Here's the 2-2. Not where he wanted that fastball to be, and it's 3-2 now. And a good battle continues as this ball's chopped foul at the plate, and the count remains 3-2. Count is full. Here's the pitch. And that misses ball four. So with one out, that'll at least set up the double play possibility here that could get them out of the inning. Dan Vogelbach comes on with one away as he looks at a ball. It's 1-0.
Now time is called, and this could very well be to buy a few more pitches for those relievers. That's lifted the other way out to left. Kim's there for it. And that's the second out of the inning. Ready for another chance? Mitch Haniger.
Yeah, we thought we might be seeing the end of the road for the starter, but clearly he's still in there for at least one more hitter.
Well, Matt, we'll see how this works out, but I think they figured with the righty coming up, it was worth sticking with him to keep the matchup advantage in their favor here.
And that misses 1-1. Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch. Slider clocked in the mid-80s there. It's a ball and two strikes. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. And he'll stay alive here as this is chopped foul at the plate. It'll remain 1-2. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive.
That's a nice pitch right there. He threw him a breaking ball, comes back with a foul.
A swing and a miss. That retires the side. And digging in to try it again.
Leading off for Baltimore, catcher Wellington Castillo.
And he waves at a curveball there. No balls and a strike. The 0-1 pitch. Oh, got him to swing out of his shoes on that one. Nothing in two.
I think a big reason why he's been so effective in this one, that he's been just about getting ahead of every hitter. Seems like every one of them are 0-2, 1-2, and it's just about every at-bat. And when that's the case, your chances of getting a good pitch to hit are way worse.
Now this is chopped fouled at home plate. It's 0-1. Hard liner, but picked up on a hop. On to first as the throw takes care of Hardy, two away. That'll bring in Joey Rickard. He's 0-for-2 with a strikeout in this one. And that misses ball one.
Well, that shot tells you everything you need to know. He's really a little frustrated tonight. This has been a tough game. They haven't swung the bats well. And
we'll have to leave it there as the play is. Here's Leonis Martin. Two base hits, both singles to this point. Vidal Nuno gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home seventh.
Your attention, please. Now pitching for Baltimore.
Too low, 1-0.
Number 54, Vidal.
Here comes the 1-0. And that changeup makes him jump, a swing and a miss.
Wow, great pitch right there, right? Changing speeds. How about that straight changeup? How about that swing? Howdy, if you're waving at me.
Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. Started the chase there. They'll appeal it down to third, and no swing. It's ball two. Now a flare out to left center. Hardy into shallow left. He's got it one away. Ready once again, Jerrod Dyson. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. Tries to catch him napping, but he missed the bunt attempt. Strike one. And now a pitch on the way. Swing and a liner. Foul. We're in the seventh inning now of a pitcher's duel. 2-1 our score. Line toward the alley in left center. And he will make the play out there, and there are two away now. Gene Segura standing in. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. Now he'll step off. Michael Givens takes over pitching duties, looking to get that final out now here in this seventh inning. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Swing and a miss way behind the big fastball.
When you're facing this good a hitter, man, that strike one becomes so important. To get ahead with him and make him think about something else, now you can control the at-bat.
0-2 count. Here's the pitch. And this pitch is up and in as he backs away. It's ball one.
Not sure if that was a purpose pitch or not, but I liked it. As a pitcher, sometimes you've got to be willing to back the guy off the plate by running something hard inside. You can't just let guys be comfortable standing in the batter's box against
you. Oh, that grounder got him. Great support from his infield, though, as that's the third out. Weird way to end the inning. At the plate, Adam Jones. He'll have the first crack at it here. As we start inning number eight. Nick Vincent.
Adam.
Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Swing and a miss at a first pitch changeup. Nothing in one. Swing and a miss. It's 0-2. Swing and a liner. Foul. The 0-2 pitch. There's a fastball that just misses. Ball one. And that is swung on and missed by Jones as he becomes out number one. Here's Manny Machado now. Three at-bats for him in this one, all ending with him going down on strikes. First pitch hack in here, and that's the first strike. Swing and a miss, and he's quickly in the hole, 0-2. Here it comes, 0-2. And this is fouled back and out of play. Ready with another 0-2. Inside as he might be trying to set him up here, 1-2. And the pitch. And this one's chopped foul right at home plate. Grounded slowly to the left side. Barehanded by Segura. Oh, and he overshoots his first baseman as it's over his head. Fortunately, the catcher's there to back things up. Here's Mark Trumbo now. He's 2 for 3 thus far.
Designated hitter, Mark Trumbo.
First pitch coming. Here it is. And that's cut on and missed, 0-1.
Tell you what, man, he looks locked in to me. You know, I played with a guy named Larry Milburn. He said he looks hitterish. You see that swing right there? I know he missed it, but he was on it.
Line drive to center field, and that's in there. Base hit. Now batting. Chris Davis, 0-for-3 with a couple of strikeouts.
Your attention, please.
So they'll go to the bullpen now, and it'll be the left-hander here to face the upcoming left-handed batter. Oh, he just blows the fastball by him for strike one. And boy, was he ever fooled on that pitch. It's 0-2 now. He struck him out, the third time he's fanned in the game. And that'll bring up the left-handed hitting outfielder, Hyunsoo Kim, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. Caleb Joseph.
We'll
come on to pinch hit here in a big spot. Edwin Diaz.
Your attention, please. Now pitching for the Mariners. Number 39.
Now a swing and a ground ball, but a foul ball here, 0-1. And a big at-bat in this one. Two on, two away here in the eighth. Fastball called for strike two. A swing and a miss as he chased with two strikes, and that will retire the side. Here's Robbie Cano now. He'll lead things off here in this one-run contest.
Second baseman, Robinson Cano.
This is pulled into right, and that's a base hit, so a chance for some important insurance here to kick off the bottom of the eighth. And he is into second base with a leadoff double. Here's Nelson Cruz now. He's looking for hit number three here in this at-bat.
Nelson Cruz.
And he doesn't want him to get off to a big lead out there at second, so he steps off to look him back. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. And there's the fourth wide one, so now the double play perhaps in order with nobody out.
Third baseman number 15.
Digging in, Kyle Seager. He was a ground-out victim last time up. He's set. Here it comes. And they'll try and get him out in front to start the at-bat, but this misses off the plate away. It's ball one.
This is a critical point right here. things are in danger of getting away from him a little, so we'll see how he deals with it. Boy, he better get it back together here quick, because he's got two guys on already. He's starting to lose location of that strike zone. He's got to throw a strike right here.
Well, he fouls off that fastball right there, and you wonder, does he love his fastball enough to come back with it three times in a row?
Ready now, two-strike pitch on its way. A little late on this one as it's lifted the other way down the left field line. Flaherty moves over near the line as he puts it away for the first out of the inning. Here now is Mike Zunino. Comes in 1-for-2 with that home run he hit earlier. Now time is called, and this might be to buy a little time for that reliever to get loose. Zach Britton is called upon, and it's not for his usual role. Just hoping to keep the deficit at one here.
Britton, this change for the Orioles.
A swinging bunt to the mound.
Number three. Ryan,
and indeed he'll not even try as he goes to first, and that means two men are in scoring position now with two away.
Now batting.
Coming to the plate. Now, Dan Vogelbach. He flew out in his last. Danny Valencia will grab a bat to pinch hit. And they'll do so with a couple of runners in scoring position here, but with two out in the inning. And there's the fourth wide one, so they'll go after the next guy with a force at any base here and two men gone. Striding in, Mitch Haniger. No hits in three tries so far. He's struck out once. Hit sharply on the ground, and he will deliver one of the biggest at-bats of the night. It's a base hit. Tack on another here as the runner scores from second, and it's a 4-1 game. And he's safe. They'll extend their lead here as the runner scores from first, make it 5-1. Digging in, Leonis Martin. Two hits in three at-bats for him in this one. Scorched to third. Throw on to Davis, takes care of him, and that'll end the inning. So striding in, Jonathan Schoop. He comes in 0-for-2 thus far. And we kick off the ninth inning with a swinging strike here, nothing and one. And a foul pop behind the plate. And that's going to land foul. On its way, the 0-2 pitch. He takes something off there as this is swung on and missed, and there's one gone here in the ninth. Here comes the first pitch. High in the air out towards shallow right. Waiting on it is Haniger. He's got it, and there are two down now. Now in the box, J.J. Hardy. He comes to the plate as the last chance for his side. Two out here in the ninth. In there for strike one. And this will be a called strike two. And trouble now as they're down to their final strike tonight. Baltimore, good night. Well, we watched a really solid starting pitching performance, kept the opposition at bay, and as a result, he's our top player of the game.
Yeah, he really put together a commanding pitching performance out there. Ended up tallying 12 strikeouts, and more importantly, he gave his team a great chance to earn the victory.
Our final line score tonight, first for the victorious Seattle Mariners. 5 runs on 9 hits. 2 errors. They left 7 men on base. For the Orioles, 1 run, 4 hits, no errors. They left 7 men on base. The winning pitcher is Felix Hernandez. The loss goes to you.